now about the lady that you've been just like wanting to hear. Yes. So I'll tell you about some of these things. I mean, no bio can describe Kiran Bedi right now, but then I'll touch upon a few things which you might not know. She was born in a tennis playing family. While still in school, she became a junior national tennis champion at the age of 16, an Asian tennis champion at the age of 22, and was ranked India's number one of her time. Absolutely. Dr. Kiran Bedi is the first woman in India to have joined the officer ranks of Indian Police Service in 1972, many, many years before I was born. She served it for 35 years, and we all know her for this. She's the recipient of the Raymond Magsaysay Award, also called Asia's Nobel Peace Prize Award, for bringing about a positive relationship between police and the people, which is such a difficult thing and has always been. Dr. Bedi has been voted as the most admired and trusted woman in India by Reader's Digest, The Week magazine, and others over the years. We are honored to have her today. And before we move into the session, I want to tell all of you all this: on this International Women's Day, Dr. Kiran Bedi received a baton of honor and an appreciation letter from Honorable President of India, President Kovind, at the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Before I give it to Ashu to play a small clip about Dr. Kiran Bedi, I want to just express that, ma'am, when I did not have any fascination with Bollywood actresses or anybody, you were one of the people who always had our respect. You came on screen and you just had it. So we're looking forward to hear from you as much today.
An old friend, and I'm her ardent admirer, have been over the years. So anyway, the theme for today is the power is your radical self. Find it. Have you ever dreamt of a life full of laughter, love, and sequence, but felt clueless about how to make it happen? Falling in love with yourself is called radical love. You are a worthy human being. You are worthy of all your activities. You are deserving. You are allowed to be happy in your skin. Ladies, throw out your self-esteem that says, I'm okay. No, that's not right. You are not okay. You are a spectacular person. You are a gem with polished edges. You are a shimmering, exploding supernova. To bring us to speed, there is no one else but Dr. Kiran Bedi to dive us into the power of radical love. Welcome, Kiranji. We have been so excited to have you with us this evening. You are the frontline leader of our times, a policeman, a politician, an IPS officer, social activist, and an ultimate motivator. The floor is yours now, and I'm the one to shoot the questions. So should we begin? In your opinion, is radical self-love, and why is it important?
The issue is you've got to begin with respecting yourself.
Right.
All our lives, everybody's different, but unless you respect yourself and love yourself, how will you respect and love others?
True.
I love myself, I respect myself, I empower myself, I enrich myself, I energize myself because I want to do it for others. So therefore, to me, this is the message. If I don't look after myself, how will I be able to be a giver? If I don't have inbuilt knowledge, and if I read for myself, how will I pass your test, Nina? I have to pass your test unless I... So the point here is we all ourselves first do it for ourselves. We don't do it for others. I know my mommy always did it for others. I don't like it. Mommy only did it for others. But she remained healthy for us because she wanted us to be looked after. But I wish mommy could have done something more to herself. I have realized where mommy went wrong, because mommy gave everything to herself at sacrifice. And mommy could have lived longer had she looked after herself a little more than all the time nurturing and caring, not only bringing us up, even our grandchildren, our own grandchildren. So what I'm doing is, I am just, first of all, nourishing myself because I love myself. And why? Because I love others. Because in the end, it's about living together. So Nina, for me, why is it important? Because for me, rest of you are important. And therefore, I make myself important so that I make others important and feel important.
Kiranjit, you have proved this in the entire time you have spent in your growing up, in your work, in your activities. You have given so much of yourself, but yes, you have groomed yourself to the position that you are in today. And we are certainly very, very proud of you.
Thank you so much, Nina. You always said that.
Yes, I surely am. Surely am. Okay, so you want me to do the next question for you? You have it. Or should I read? I'll read it. As someone has so rightly said, both our first and last love is self-love, as you have rightly said. What is your opinion on the same?
It is, because mine is not selfish love. It's not selfish love. When you say self-love, it's not selfish love. It's self-love, knowing yourself first. And what are my strengths? And what are the strengths I can give to others to strengthen others? So my life is all about strengthening others, empowering others. But if I don't empower myself, how will I be in a position to give? So therefore, we women actually forget our own selves. We don't nourish our own selves, educate ourselves enough, even financially empower ourselves. I first financially empowered myself. Once I make myself financially secured, I'm in a position to give. So I think it's a matter of doing it selflessly through the self.
Great, yes. But why is it hard for us to provide the same level of support for ourselves as we would for others? We always end up doing that. Why?
Why we do that? I think comes from probably not understanding. I think it's more of sense. It's like being martyrs. Why should we be martyrs? Women need not be martyrs. Women must live. We become martyrs. So I am not a martyr. I want to live and live for others. And therefore, I spend for myself. I provide for myself. I get support systems for myself. I equip myself only so that I can then empower others. Always, I think that's the point. I'm a product of a very effective, very generous support system. Very generous. I like that because the support system also gets empowered in the process. All my supporting staff have houses. All my supported staff's children are educated. All my supportive staff's children are also employed. So the point here is, I find a support system which saves me my time so that I get energized. But in the process, my supportive staff also gets empowered.
That's what you are. That is your strength. And you have followed this through your life journey. And, you know, you have supported so many people, whether they have liked it or not. But that doesn't matter. That doesn't deter you in any way. And that's where the strength comes, not only for yourself, but all of us who are actually watching you and reading about you from day to day. You have no idea how much we love you and support you in all your endeavors. If we refuse to accept our faults, we refuse the opportunity to grow. Your take on this?
Yeah, why not? Every day is an evolving day. Every day is a growth day. Every day is a learning day. I don't know so much. In fact, one life is not enough. So inadequacies, maybe not faults, but your inadequacies. You know, why would they be a fault? I think there would be deficiencies and inadequacies. So once you realize that this is my deficiency, why can't I do my, it's like nutrition. If I know I need multivitamins, I pick them up from the market. That's an internal deficiency where I want my, so why not? That's why we go to a doctor to find out our physical deficiencies. That's why we go to the Gita classes to find out our spiritual deficiencies. Similarly, we also have deficiencies in social relationships. It's good to know and keep improving. I have substantially grown and learned through my social networking.
Great, my God. Very important question. How should the opposite gender be sensitized about women and their feelings? Very important question.
We need mothers. Others,
true.
Mothers,
yes.
And fathers, yeah. And more than the father, mothers. The mother. Is the mother is the biggest sensitizer of her son, and a sensitized son will produce a sensitized man and a father. So I think the ball is in our court. We as mothers.
Absolutely, I mean they are the ones who really carry the generations through, and we are actually the ones who are executing those efforts.
That's true.
And even so the you're absolutely
teachers.
Right.
And it the teachers in
women,
school.
Women.
Pardon? Even the teachers in school. So mothers at home, yeah. And teachers in school, men and women.
Correct, correct. That is true. We are all together in it. And it's actually our own morals that we project on our children and see how they grow. And we, in a big way, are responsible for what they are today. Anyway. What would you tell your young women who are just starting to work?
First, be self-reliant. Before you get into motherhood and being a wife, be very self-reliant economically and mentally, physically, and spiritually. Be self-reliant. Very, very important. Once you're self-reliant, get into an empowered relationship of internal support system, not dependence. I want interdependence. I don't want dependence. I want interdependence. So never be in a rush. Find your feet. Don't be in a rush. But if you say, oh, this man will go away if I don't get married now, you may be making a mistake. So first be self-reliant economically. Economic self-reliance, psychological self-reliance is very, very important before you get into relationships of marriage. Relationship of marriage. Because marriage is a longer bond. Relationships will come and go. But a marriage is a very important longer bond because children come out of it. Because children need both. So I would rather say, if you're going to decide to get married, first be 100% self-reliant and be in a position to give rather than receive. So don't expect. Give. Be a giver even in marriage.
Well, you're right. It is a consensual relationship and we have to honor that. In order to make it happen, I mean, look what is happening in the world today. People are falling apart at the drop of a hat. So this consensual relationship between a man and a woman is absolutely utmost to bring up a healthy generation. So anyway, now, I do think we are running out of time, but tell me, give us a message for this Wiki forum that we are on today.
Go all out to empower other women in need. All out to empower, because when you empower a woman, you're reaching the whole family.
That is
do
true.
All, and you are a great organization. Find your own small or big ways, individually and collectively as you're doing. Please go on in empowering. That's what I'm doing. And I've noticed Harbin has already helped me. My NGOs come on your economic platform. And now my rural women are now going to be selling Unnati products. Thank you, Harbin. You brought me onto the platform, and Manjula and others have recognized it. See, these are poor rural women, so they are now from poor to rich. So let's start making a movement, women poor to rich.
So the moral of the story, start living from your hearts. Fall in love with life. People do not take charge of their lives, are largely charged by time. आप जब भी परेशान हो तो आईने के सामने जाकर खड़े हो जाओ सामने आपके एक व्यक्ति नजर आएगा यही वो व्यक्ति है जो आपकी हर समस्या का हल पाएगा कर पाएगा दिस इज योर पावर ऑफ रैडिकल सेल्फ लव लिटिल फ्यू लाइंस फ्रॉम ओपरा द मोर यू प्रेज एंड सेलिब्रेट योर लाइफ द मोर देयर इज इन लाइफ टू सेलिब्रेट So celebrate life. Every step you take it with celebration. This is our life. Nobody else is going to take it. So atmavishwas, aapki sabse badi shakti hai. So rely on yourself and let's move forward in a collective manner.
Truly, truly, Kiranji, you are truly a unique and a rare soul. And it is our utmost honor to confer on you our highest award of Wiki 2021 of the legendary women of the decade in nation building and community service. Only 6 or 8 women in the world have the Legendary Women of the Decade Award. You are absolutely the leading light for us and the top 10 women in the world and icons for all of us. Thank you, Kiranji.
Thank you. Thank you for so much of your love. Lovely, really impressive. Maja aa gaya. Maja aa gaya. Maja aa gaya. Thank you. Bless you.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Nina.